it felt like a responsibility to explore all of the aspects of the legacy of this sneaker. It felt like a responsibility to sort of present the facts and not in a way revise or rewrite history. I think anybody that knows anything about the Air Jordan sneaker will know that, you know, these senseless crimes and this senseless, you know, violence has always kind of gone hand in hand with the shoe. And I think that dates back to like the early 80s. So I kind of just felt that it was appropriate for us, you know, to show almost like this cause and effect, kind of like flow and pace and rhythm of the film. You know, the first 60, 70 minutes is a celebration of the shoe, but there's no other way to sort of like tell that story. It, you know, the reason why the third act happens is because the shoe was so popular or remains so popular. So I thought it was really important, but just more important as, you know, as a director to sort of present all of the facts and then just leave it to the discretion of the viewer to make their own mind up over, you know, corporations and how they market to us and the byproduct of all of those things. The entry point to making this film was always fandom. It was always kind of like an obsession with, you know, an African-American man being the god of basketball and the Chicago Bulls being a really, really popular and successful franchise. And I wanted to look at the byproduct of that, which was the Air Jordan, and tell this almost like warts and all story that didn't shy away from the more difficult elements of this shoe's legacy. We don't guide the viewer to sort of like make a conclusion on any of this because I don't think it's black and white, you know, so I don't think it would therefore be irresponsible of us as filmmakers to sort of, you know, have an agenda like that. I think it's quite complicated. I think that Michael Jordan is not responsible if some idiot wants to pick up a gun and then, you know, pursue a kid for some Air Jordans. I don't think that's Michael Jordan's responsibility. What I do think is that the objective of any business is to make money. And I think perhaps when that is at the heart of your business model, then that is gonna play, it's gonna make your moral compass be a bit skewed. Your moral compass is gonna be a bit haywire if, you know, it comes to injustices that surround this sneaker and this community. I don't think it's necessarily for us to sort of have any expectation of these businesses and these corporations when, you know, they're concerned about the bottom line. So having spoke to a lot of the parents that have kind of like been involved in this and who have lost sort of like sons or daughters, I think the overriding sort of like take that I got is that they didn't necessarily blame the brand, but I think they just wanted some sort of acknowledgement that this happened. And I think that's what aggrieved many of the parents that I spoke to personally, just they had just the silence, you know, from the brands and not an acknowledgement. I think, you know, Daisy Williams says it in the film that she doesn't blame Nike or Michael Jordan for her son, you know, being senselessly gunned down. But, you know, they can say something. And I think, you know, that's all they've ever wanted. So, yeah, my personal opinion is that it's complicated. It's not black and white. But I also feel that, you know, these businesses are set up and designed to sort of like sell stuff to us and therefore make lots of money. And I think that if that is, you know, that is your God, that is your bottom line, and that's at the heart of your business model, when it comes to issues of humanity, then we shouldn't necessarily expect lots from them.